Sir Speaker, in order to improve the capital flows into the Indian economy, it is important to align domestic corporate systems and practices with global ones. It is also appreciated that global finance movement in equity uses certain parameters to evaluate the stocks in which they choose to invest. The government intends to further encourage retail participation in CPSEs, which of late has shown very encouraging upward trend. In order to provide additional investment space, the government would realign its holding in CPSEs, including banks, to permit greater availability of its shares and to improve depth of its market. Strategic disinvestment of select CPSEs would continue to remain a priority of this government. In view of current macroeconomic parameters, government would not only reinitiate the process of strategic disinvestment of Air India, but would offer more CPSEs for strategic participation by the private sector. I repeat this sentence: strategic disinvestment of select CPSEs would continue to remain a priority for this government. In view of current macroeconomic parameters, government would not only reinitiate the process of strategic disinvestment of Air India, but also would offer more CPSEs for strategic participation by the private sector. Government is setting an enhanced target of ₹1,05,000 crore of disinvestment receipts for the financial year 2019-20. The government will undertake strategic sale of PSUs. The government will also continue to do consolidation of PSUs in the non-financial space as well. Sir, ETFs have proved to be an important investment opportunity for retail investors and has turned out to be a good instrument of Government of India's disinvestment program. To expand this further, government will offer an investment option in ETFs on the line of Equity Linked Savings Scheme, which is ELSS. This would encourage long-term investments in CPSEs. For bringing better public ownership of the PSUs and also bring greater commercial and market orientation of the listed PSUs, the government will take all necessary steps to meet public shareholding norms of 25% for all listed PSUs and raise the foreign shareholding limits to maximum permissible sector limits for all PSUs, companies which are part of emerging market index. Sir, the Indian sovereign debt, external debt, India's sovereign external debt to GDP is among the lowest globally at less than 5%. Honourable Speaker, sir, this is a very important indicator for India. I am repeating the line. India's sovereign external debt to GDP is among the lowest globally at less than 5%. The government will start raising a part of its gross borrowing program in external markets in external currencies. This will also have beneficial impact on demand situation for the government securities in domestic market. A new series of coins, sir, a new series of coins of 1 rupee, 2 rupees, 5 rupees, 10 rupees and 20 rupees, easily identifiable to the visually impaired also, were released by the government minister, by the Honourable Prime Minister on 7th March 2019. These new coins will be made available for public use shortly. Sir, in the first 50 years after independence, we emphasized on rights. So I draw your attention to this line, which marks the end of part A of my speech. In the first 50 years after independence, we emphasized on rights. Marking 75 years of our independence, we should place emphasis on our duty towards India.